Hello and welcome to Brush My Concern. Today we will be talking about how to deal with probability problems involving rolling a dice. If you wish to receive regular updates from us, then consider subscribing to the channel by clicking on the subscribe icon to the right bottom of your screen. So let's get started with today's topic of how to deal with probability problems involving rolling a dice. So we will be starting with understanding the definition of probability of an event. Then we'll talk about probability of rolling one dice, look at some of the examples, then probability of rolling two dice, and then we will look at some of the example problems on rolling two dice. So let's start with definition of probability of an event. So probability of an event is nothing but the likelihood of occurrence of that event. That means if you're talking about an event E, then probability of occurrence of an event E is denoted by P of E, and it is equal to number of successful outcomes divided by total number of outcomes. Now let's understand this by taking an example. So if we are talking about probability of rolling one dice, then what are the total number of outcomes? So as you rightly guess, the total number of outcomes will be nothing but 6. And if we list down those outcomes, then the outcomes will be nothing but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or we can even get a 6. Now, if I ask you, what is the probability of getting 1? So we know that probability of any event is equal to number of successful outcomes divided by total number of outcomes. So if I have to get a 1, I can see that out of the 6 outcomes which are there, there is only one such case in which I can get a 1. Right? So probability of getting a 1 will be nothing but 1 divided by 6. Similarly, probability of getting a 2 or getting a 3, 4, 5 or 6 will also be equal to 1 divided by 6, because all of them occur only once out of all of those 6 outcomes. Now, what is the probability that the number which we are getting is greater than 3? So if you look at the 6 outcomes, there are 3 such numbers, 4, 5 and 6, which are actually greater than 3. So if we have to find the probability that the number is greater than 3, will be nothing but 3 divided by 6, or will be equal to 1 divided by 2. Now, what is the probability of getting an odd number? So out of the 6 outcomes, we know there are 3 outcomes, 1, 3 and 5, which are actually odd numbers, right? So probability of getting an odd number will also be equal to 3 by 6. Will be nothing but equal to 1 by 2. What about getting even numbers? So out of the 6 outcomes, again, 3 outcomes, 2, 4, and 6 are even. So probability of getting an even number is also equal to 3 by 6, will be nothing but equal to 1 by 2. What about probability of getting a prime number? Now, first of all, if you don't know what is a prime number, then check out the link in the description of this video where I have recorded a video explaining what is a prime number also. So let's see what are the different prime numbers. We know that prime numbers are numbers which have only two multiples, one and the number itself. So out of the 6 numbers, we know 2 is a prime number, 3 is a prime number, and 5 is a prime number. So probability of getting a prime number will also be equal to 3 by 6 and nothing but equal to 1 by 2. Now let's see, how do we deal with problems where we are rolling two dice instead of rolling a single dice? So what are the total number of outcomes? So in the first dice, we can get any number out of 1 to 6. So in the first dice, the total number of outcomes possible are 6. Similarly, for each of those 6 outcomes, in the second dice, we can also get any of those 6 numbers. So the total outcomes will be nothing but equal to 6 raised to 2 or nothing but 36. So if you are rolling n dice, then total number of outcomes in case of n dice will be nothing but 6 raised to n. Now, what are those outcomes? So in the first dice, you can get a 1. In the second dice, you can also get a 1. If you get 1 in the first dice, you can get a 2 all the way to 6. In the first dice, you can get a 2. In the second dice, you can get a 1 all the way till 2, 6. Similarly, you can get a 3, 1, 4, 1, and so on, all the way till 6, 1. And then you can get all the numbers till 6,6. So these are those 36 outcomes which you can get when you are rolling two dice. Now let's see some example problems on rolling two dice. So what is the probability that both outcomes will be odd? So let's list down those outcomes in which both the outcomes are odd. So we have two places. In the first place, I can get any number out of 1, 3, and 5. In the second place, also I can get any number out of 1, 3, and 5. So for the first place, I have three choices. For the second place, also I have three choices. So total number of favorable outcomes will be nothing but 9. So probability that both outcomes are odd will be nothing but 9 divided by 36, or will be equal to 1 by 4. Now, what is the probability that both outcomes are even? Again, I have two places to fill. In the first place, I can get any of the even numbers, which are 2, 4, and 6. Similarly, in the second place also, I need to get any of the even numbers, which are 2, 4, and 6. For the first place, I have three choices. Second place also, I have three choices. So total choices become 9. And the probability becomes 9 divided by 36, or nothing but 1 by 4. What is the probability that both outcomes are prime? Again, we have two places. Both the places have to be prime, so the numbers can be 2, 3, or 5. So again, we have 3 into 3, 9 choices which are possible, and the probability becomes 9 by 36, or nothing but 1 by 4. Now, what is the probability that sum of the two outcomes is an odd number? So we have two places to fill, and the sum of the two outcomes has to be odd. So let's say in the first place we have 1. So for the sum to be odd, the other number has to be even. That means for the second place, I have three choices, which are nothing but 2, 4, and 6. Let's say the first place we got a 2. So the second place has to be an odd number now for the sum to be odd. So for the second place, I have three choices, 1, 3, and 5. Similarly, in the first one, if we got a 3, again, we have three choices, which are 2, 4, and 6. If we got a 4 in the first roll, then in the second one, we need to get an odd number. So again, we have three choices, which are 1, 3, and 5. If in the first roll we got a 5, then again, for the second one, we need to get an even number. So we can get 2, 4, or 6, three choices. In the first roll, if you got a 6, for the second roll, we need to get an odd number. So we can get any number out of 1, 3, and 5. So what are the total number of favorable outcomes? In each of them, we got 3 choices. So in total, we have 3 into 6 choices, and overall number of choices are 36. So this is nothing but equal to 1 by 2. Now, how do we find sum of the two outcomes to be even? Again, we will follow the same method. For the sum of the two outcomes to be even, both the outcomes either should be odd or both the outcomes should be even. So if we take 1 in the first case, in the second case, we need to get an odd number. So 1, 3, 5. If we take 2 in the first roll, then in the second roll, we need to get an even number. Similarly, 3 will follow the same pattern, and 5 will follow the same pattern. Here, 4 will follow the same pattern, and 6 will follow the same pattern. So overall number of choices again becomes 3 into 6 divided by total number of choices, which is 36. And this is also equal to 1 by 2. Now, what is the probability that sum of the two outcomes is a prime number? So how do we find a prime number? So we have two choices. Let's say in the first one, we got a 1. We know prime numbers in this range will be 2, 3, 5, and 7. So in order to get a 2, I can put the number as 1,1. In order to get 3, I can put 1,2. For 5, I can put 1,4. And for 7, I can put 1,6. Similarly, if I get 2 in the first roll, I can put 2,1 to get 3, 2,3 to get 5, 2,5 to get 7. If I get a 3 in the first roll, 3 comma 2 to get 5, 3 comma 4 to get 7, and after 7, 3 comma 6 will be 9. So that is not a prime number. So we can move on to 4. So 4 comma 1, and then 4 comma 3 to get 7. And the next prime number is 11. We cannot get it by 4. So let's move on to 5. So 5 comma 2 to get 7, and 5 comma 6 to get 11. Similarly, 6 comma 1 to get 7, and 6 comma 5 to get 11. So total number of favorable outcomes in this case will be 4 plus 3, 7. 7 plus 4 is 11, and 11 plus 4 is 15. So total number of favorable outcomes is 15 divided by 36, or nothing but equal to 5 divided by 12 in this case. Now, sum of the two outcomes is a multiple of 3. We know we can get numbers only from 1, 1 to 6, 6. That means the sum of the two numbers can be between 2 to 12. And the multiples of 3 between 2 to 12 are 3, 6, 9, and 12. So let's say if we get a 1 in the first roll, then we can get 2 in the second roll to make the sum as 3. 1, 5 to make it as 6. 2, 1, 2, 4. 3, 3, 3, 6. 4, 2, 4, 5. 5 and 1, 5 and 4, 6 and 3, and 6 and 6. So these are the total favorable outcomes, which are nothing but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So sum of the two outcomes to be a multiple of 3, probability of that is nothing but 12 by 36, or nothing but 1 by 3. Now, what is the probability that the sum of the two outcomes is a multiple of 5? We know the sum is between 2 to 12, and the multiples of 5 between 2 to 12 are 5 and 10. So if we get 1 in the first case, we can get 4 in the second one. If we get 2 in the first case, we can get 2, 3, 3, 2, 4, 1, 4, 6, 5, 5, and 6, 4. So these are the favorable outcomes, which are nothing but 7 of them. So the sum of the two outcomes is a multiple of 5. The probability of that will be nothing but equal to 7 divided by 36. Now let's look at more examples. So what is the probability that the product of the two outcomes is a prime number? So for the product of the two outcomes to be a prime number, one of them should be 1. And other one should be the prime number. So if you are getting 1 in the first case, we can get any of the numbers from 2, 3, and 5 in the second case. So 3 outcomes. Similarly, we can get 2, 1, 3, 1, and 5, 1. So in total, we have 6 favorable outcomes divided by total number of outcomes, which is 36, making this as 1 by 6. What is the probability that the product of the two outcomes is a multiple of 3? Now, for the product to be a multiple of 3, either or both of the two outcomes have to be a multiple of 3. That means we can get 1, 3, 2, 3, 4, 3, or 5, 3, or any of the 6 outcomes from 3, 1 all the way till 3, 6, and from 6, 1 all the way till 6, 6. So in total, we have 6 plus 6, 12 outcomes, plus 4 outcomes, which is nothing but 16 outcomes out of 36, which will be equal to 8 by 18, and will be also equal to 4 divided by 9. Now, what is the probability that product of the two outcomes is a multiple of 5? Again, either of the two outcomes have to be a multiple of 5. So we can get 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4, 5, and 6, 5. And any of the 6 outcomes from 5, 1 all the way till 5, 6. So in total, we have 6 plus 5 or nothing but 11 outcomes out of 36, in which the product of the two outcomes will be a multiple of 5. Hope you were able to understand how to deal with probability problems involving rolling a dice. If you did, please go ahead and like the video, provide your valuable comments, do share the videos with your friends, and consider subscribing to the channel to get regular updates from us. Thank you for your time.